Behind me is the USS Midway. And I'm gonna talk about it. The USS Midway, a staple of naval history, takes its name from the pivotal Battle of Midway in June 1942. Commissioned on September 10, 1945, the Midway missed World War II by just 1 week, and remarkably, this floating fortress was built in a mere 17 months. During the Cold War, the Midway made history as the first American carrier to operate in the midwinter subarctic conditions in 1946. The ship even launched a captured German V-2 rocket in 1947, marking the beginning of naval missile warfare. Serving with the Atlantic Fleet for a decade, the Midway made 7 deployments to European waters, patrolled NATO, and relocated to the West Coast in 1955. It was then rebuilt with an angled deck to improve jet operations. In 1965, the Midway saw its first combat deployment, flying strikes against northern Vietnam. It scored the first air kill of the Vietnam War, but 17 of its aircraft were lost due to enemy fire. Fast forward to April 1975, and the Midway became a floating base for large Air Force helicopters during Operation Frequent Wind, evacuating over 3,000 refugees from Saigon. In 1990, the Midway deployed to the Persian Gulf in response to Iraq's seizure of Kuwait. Serving as the flagship during Operation Desert Storm, it launched over 3,000 combat missions without a single loss. The Midway's final mission was the evacuation of civilian personnel from Clark Air Force Base in the Philippines following the eruption of Mount Pinatubo. In June of 2004, it opened as the USS Midway Museum, and it stands as a testament to its storied past, welcoming visitors from around the world to experience its legacy firsthand. The USS Midway was first opened to the public in 2004, marking the start of its history as a museum. Since its inception as a museum, the USS Midway has become a staple of San Diego tourism, captivating visitors from around the world. As of 2015, it stands as one of the city's most popular attractions, drawing crowds eager to experience its rich history firsthand. Admission to the USS Midway Museum includes access to immersive self-guided audio tours, allowing visitors to explore at their own pace while delving deeper into the ship's fascinating history. In 2012, the USS Midway made headlines as it played host to a historic NCAA basketball game between Syracuse and San Diego State. The iconic setting provided a memorable backdrop for sports fans and players alike. Since 2017, the USS Midway has also been home to the annual Battle on the Midway event, where visitors can witness thrilling performances, military reenactments, and spectacular fireworks displays, all set against the breathtaking backdrop of the San Diego skyline. Beyond its role as a museum, the USS Midway is a dynamic event space, hosting over 700 events each year. From corporate functions to weddings, the ship offers a unique setting that leaves a lasting impression on all who attend. Now, on my trip to the Midway, my very first stop were the living quarters. And this made me think about what the daily life was like for someone who lived on an aircraft carrier. So we asked Mr. Jeff Bradley. He was a Navy pilot during the Vietnam War, and he spent a lot of time on these aircraft carriers.
So what aspects of everyday life on board the carrier do you miss the most, and are there any lessons or habits you carried with you from your time serving on board?
Yeah, there's probably only one thing I really miss about being on the ship, and that's flying. Flying a jet fighter is just a... You can't imagine how good it is and how interesting it is and how complicated it is. Fantastic. As far as missing things, you miss the people. I still have friends from 50 years ago, and you have a particularly close bond with people that you've been in combat with. The things that you developed a great, I want to say, discipline and habits as far as just simple things like being on time to doing things right. You just had to do that. So I had great experience in learning things from that.
After seeing the living quarters, I decided to go up and see the flight deck. And the flight deck is basically like the runway of the ship. And that's where they have all the planes on display and stuff like that. And as I was walking around, something that came as a surprise to me was how big the planes are, how big the fighter jets are. I always kind of assumed that like they are like small and quick and nimble, but they're actually pretty big, and I don't know, that just came as a shock to me. I also got a free tour out of this trip, and I don't think I was supposed to. I think I just got dragged into one, but I mean, that was nice. They took us through the living quarters, and they took us through the dining room and stuff like that. Basically just the part of the ship where all the sailors like hang out. Another fun thing I noticed at the museum were all of the helicopters that you could walk inside of and the cockpits that you can sit in. That's just a little thing that makes it a lot more fun, so I don't know, I just thought it was pretty cool. But yeah, that concludes this video about the USS Midway, both its history and its museum, so I hope you guys liked it. I know I had a really good time making it, so yeah, see ya.